Hey there, Swarmers! Welcome back to The Hive. In previous videos, we've talked about the important role our oceans play in carbon sequestration. Remember, carbon sequestration is the natural or artificial process by which carbon dioxide is removed from the atmosphere and held in solid or liquid form. While terrestrial forests are the most efficient natural carbon sequesters on our planet, absorbing a third of our anthropogenic emissions, our oceans are the largest carbon sequesters, also absorbing almost 30% of our emissions. That's roughly 2 billion metric tons of carbon each year. Some of the incredible marine ecosystems that are invaluable in that carbon sequestration are the kelp forests that dominate coastal environments in temperate and subpolar latitudes around the globe. Kelp is a type of macroalgae that grows in dense groupings, much like a forest on land. It can reach to well over 100 feet long in ideal conditions. These underwater towers of kelp provide food and shelter for thousands of fish, invertebrates, and marine mammal species. Many fish species use kelp forests as nurseries for their young, while seabirds and marine mammals like sea lions, sea otters, and even gray whales use them as shelter from predators and storms. Recent research suggests that in addition to creating beautiful habitats, macroalgae such as kelp play a large role reducing the effects of global warming. Through photosynthesis, kelp convert carbon dioxide and sunlight into sugars that are used for energy. This translates into an incredibly fast growth rate, up to 2 feet per day. Ultimately, large portions of this kelp biomass ends up exported out into the deep sea, where it is either consumed by other marine animals or falls to the deep sea floor, allowing kelp to permanently remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. A paper published in 2016 in Nature Geosciences estimated that roughly 200 million tons of carbon dioxide are being sequestered by macroalgae, including kelp, every year. That's about as much as the annual emissions of the state of New York. If that wasn't enough to impress you, kelp forests also protect coastlines against the effect of storm surges and sea level rise. And they clean water by absorbing excess nutrients, heavy metals, and radioactive ions. However, globally, kelp forests are now threatened by climate change, coastal development, pollution, fishing, and invasive species. In fact, kelp forests are disappearing 4 times faster than rainforests. Since the 1960s, the kelp forests of eastern Australia and Tasmania have declined by 90% or more, while satellite imagery from this year shows that the area covered by kelp forests off the coast of Northern California has dropped by more than 95%. And has been replaced by sea urchin barrens that are nearly devoid of life. In Western Australia, increases in ocean temperatures, accentuated by an extreme spike in 2011, have killed vast beds of important native kelp. In southern Norway, ocean temperatures have exceeded the threshold for sugar kelp, which has died en masse since the late 1990s, and largely been replaced by thick mats of turf algae, which stifles kelp recovery. In Western Europe, the warming Atlantic Ocean poses a serious threat to coastal beds, and researchers have predicted local extinction as early as the first half of the 21st century in parts of France, Denmark, and southern England. The loss of these kelp forests is directly impacting all of the animals that once depended on them for survival. And we humans are losing the benefits of carbon sequestration, coastal protection, and even food production, as species that we depend on for food no longer have the protection of kelp forests for breeding grounds. So, what can we do to preserve and protect this vital natural resource? Scientists and conservation projects around the world are working to restore kelp forests by cultivating kelps in labs to reseed coastal areas, developing commercial sea urchin removal operations, and breeding and reintroducing sea stars, the natural predators of the voracious sea urchins that have decimated forests. But to keep remaining kelp forests healthy and provide the proper conditions for continued growth, it's vital that countries around the world take action against climate change to prevent further warming of our oceans. Creating no fishing zones and cutting back on the chemicals used in farming can also help protect kelp forests and the animals who live in them. How can you get involved? By living your most sustainable life and reducing your personal carbon footprint by supporting local conservation efforts and by voting for leaders who have pledged to fight climate change and protect our planet to ensure a sustainable future for all life. Thank you so much, as always, for joining us, Swarmers. We love to share this information with you so that we together can become our most sustainable selves. Hey, and don't forget, if you can, to like, share, subscribe, and even drop a comment below. We would love to chat. Stay safe, stay sustainable, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.